Good morning. It's been my mini routine these days while Carlton is eating that I'll just like fix my hair for the day. Cause I don't wash my hair every day. I used to when I was younger, oh my God, every day. My hair doesn't get as greasy these days, so if it does, I usually just dry shampoo it. If we could try to attempt to get this right. That's as down the middle as it's gonna get. Even though if I go up to the bridge of my nose and do this, there's no way. I also can't really see because I don't have my contacts in. But so when I brush out my hair, it pretty much has the wave still. Pop a little dry shampoo. And I don't know about everybody else, but I do my hair based on what I'm doing that day. And I'm not doing anything today. I might have to run out for errands, so it's like, is she going in public? Is she not? She's gonna get a little cheese silk infusion. Looking a little dry. I think I might just touch up a couple pieces, but I have to do an Amazon return today. Well, it doesn't have to be today. I might go another day, but you can return Amazon at Kohl's. I bought a new pillow and I don't like it, so it's going back. Keep my conscious clean, cause while I'm so walked in here to fart and then walked out. That was nasty. Making coffee in a pot.
That's a wet man drink.
What mug do we want to use today?
Oh yeah, always this one. This one with the beaks.
Writing down, you know, all the rooms that we have to get done and all the chores that need to get done, because for whatever reason, we're those people who let it pile up. We're not like, oh, do a little here, do a little there. I mean, yeah, a little maintenance cleaning, but it usually just overflows and we have to do it all at once. So here's the list. We had this random idea. If you don't look forward to your chores, maybe this will help. 6 quadrants for 6 areas that need to be cleaned. Boxes for all of the tasks that need to get done. We got to thinking, why don't we cut these all up, make a little game out of it, put it in a jar, and just whatever task you get, that's what you're on. So that's what we're gonna do.
Let's do it.
Okay, jar. I've got the chores. There's probably some crumbs in that drawer. Drawer? Jar still. Okay, babe. Shake it up.
You go first.
Okay. First.
First. 3, 2, 1. Bathroom toilet scrub.
Yes. Oh wait, but I got the toilet bowl the outside. So we're in the same room.
Yep, doing the same thing.
So maybe let's pick one more and then we'll separate rooms because it'll probably be in a different room and then we can like swap it. So we'll start with 2. Because we just said we want to be in different rooms so we don't get annoyed.
All right, ready? 3, 2, 1. Bedroom Windex windows and windowsills.
Wait, what the fuck? I got Windex the windows in the living room. Okay, so while I'm in the living room Windexing the windows, you could do the inside of the toilet, and yep. Then when you're Windexing the windows in the where? In the bedroom?
Which one do you want to do first, bathroom or windowsills?
I would like to do the windowsills first.
Okay, so then I'll do the bathroom toilet scrub.
Does that sound cool?
Yeah, scrub that toilet. Let's do this.
Let's go. Joke's on us. We're gonna start cleaning and we're out of mostly bathroom cleaning supplies. So we're gonna go get soft scrub and tile cleaner at CVS and then we'll be back. Catch you in a bit. And we're back. We went to Rite Aid to get the cleaning supplies because I found a coupon on the way walking out. $10 off $40. I was like, oh, you know, when you're in a convenience store, you're probably gonna see something and end up buying it and it'll equal $40. You know, the mascara you thought you didn't need. Whatever, we got there and everything we needed, they didn't have. Fabulous. So the next best thing was to go to the store next door, which was Dollar Tree. And we found everything we needed and a Beagle stocking. I mean, come on. Side note, I also found these faux mink lashes. These look amazing. Sometimes at the Dollar Tree, like they also carried LA Girl colors, and I think those lashes are a little synthetic looking, plastic looking. Not to say they're bad, but I prefer the fluffier versions when they're synthetic. It's something I can't explain. Anyway, we've got our cleaning supplies and we're ready to clean. It's my first chore is the windowsills. We bought vinegar because I feel like vinegar helps with mold. Oh, and also, as if my coffee wasn't enough, I caved.
Where's my phone?
You are
Protein! Apparently, white vinegar or vinegar is a good cleaning thing for the windowsills, and also there's a mixture that I can make using essential oils. What's the matter? Hi, Mush. I think he wants a biscuit. Our tree, the tree is stored in my dad's garage and it smells a little musty. And I've been spraying Thieves household cleaner, which is dog safe, on it, which gets rid of it temporarily. Oh, I got these at Dollar Tree. They're odor absorbent balls. And I put these in my closet for my sneakers because my sneakers were smelling a little musty and it went away. So I'm gonna try this with the tree and I need to Google that vinegar mixture. And we're gonna put on Tony Robbins' I'm Not Your Guru, which is the Date with Destiny event. We both have been to Date with Destiny. I don't care, I'm not having anybody over. We'll just stick it in there. We've been to the Date with Destiny event. And I might even do a more in-depth video on it because I have footage from it that I never used. That's why we went to Australia in 2017. And so it's always good, even if you've seen something before like that or been to something like that before, to constantly repeat it in your brain. Because even Tony Robbins preaches, repetition is the mother of skill. Why do basketball players practice? Repetition. They get better, they get stronger, muscle memory. Okay, that one's going there. I don't know if that will do anything, but a girl can try. Also, yes, it does in fact look like a train wreck in here, but that's good. It makes for a beautiful before and after. Let me show you the damage. We've got countertops, we've got dishes, we've got cleaning supplies out, we've got things that need to go away. We've got dirty floors. We've got a beagle. Poshmark items I never put away. Thanksgiving bins I never put away. We have to figure out a place to store the Christmas stuff. Not really much going on in here, but I have to throw these out. What even happened here? I don't know. Morning coffee happened. Okay, so that's that. The room. Oh yeah, here's the countertop. It's just, it's an eruption. When I tried to organize the other day and never finished. Closet. Remember it was clean last week? So yeah, if you were thinking, oh, it can't be that bad. No, it is. But like I said, an amazing before and after. So let's go.
You're so hard on yourself. I love that you have such high standards. But those aren't high standards. That's called perfection. And most people overestimate what they can do in a year. And they underestimate what they can do in 2 or 3 decades. And you haven't been around long enough to have those extra 2-3 decades. More than 4 million people around the world have attended one of his live events.
I'll give you a list of people that you have. Bill Clinton, President Biden, Mikhail Gorbachev, Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela. These are like the icons of my lifetime.
I would do these incantations, but I would say over and over again, I'm fucking stop. I would get up and I had no money. And I'd say, God's wealth is circulating my life in avalanches of abundance. All my needs, desires, and goals are met instantaneously by infinite intelligence. I'm one with God, and God is everything. I see God's wealth in the love, the friendships, the insights, the ideas, and the emotions. Fucking energy in my body, in my soul, my hunger, my desire.
My next chore is... So I was vacuuming something. I was vacuuming over here. It looked like a little piece of pine tree or something. I don't know. And then the thing got sucked up and the vacuum shut off and then it smelled like smoke. It smelled like fire. So here we are undoing the vacuum to see what the heck burnt and if this is totaled.
Yeah, that's way too fragile. I do not want to touch that.
Okay, should we look on YouTube? So, Dyson vacuums are apparently very difficult to open. Something definitely sparked on fire or burnt in there. We realized that the Dyson support people, they're closed right now, so when they're ready to be open, we'll call them. So I guess we're gonna move on to the next chore. What's next for me? This one feels good. Let's see. Next chore is... Oh shoot. It says floor vacuum floor mop.
So it looks like it's only a mop.
No, we can't mop without vacuuming first.
Oh yeah?
So... Next! Tidy up bins in the closet. Okay. Good. I'm getting the closet. Ding! It's 6:14. We have done so much deep cleaning. Drew actually went out to get his own dinner. I'm heating up a HelloFresh from the other night, which was Thai ginger curry. But everywhere got a deep clean, like mirrors, counters, floors, toilets, bathtub, mirrors. Obviously the vacuum cracked out. This is all my Poshmark stuff, not my jacket, but everything else. And the bedroom's still in the works. I'm gonna make a list of what I have to clean for tomorrow. But yeah, today was just a strict ass cleaning day. I think that's gonna do it for me today. Because it's 6 o'clock and I still have to put up my other vlog. That's that. Do you have your food?
Yep.
Yay, okay, that's a wrap. Peace out. See you tomorrow.